viernes, yo soy Rory, hoy es viernes y estoy contento de estar aquí contigo. Durante las últimas semanas nosotros tuvimos una serie de videos con Hilda y Silvia. So for the last few weeks we've had a series of videos, most of the month of July actually, a series of videos from Hilda and Silvina, who were telling us all about their perspectives on working with patients and patient perspectives in our healthcare system. So if you missed those, head over to YouTube or look at the blog, look in the Facebook group and find those videos, because they were averaged, I don't know, 5 to 7 minutes and pure Spanish. So great for your listening comprehension. Awesome for you intermediate advanced level speakers, probably a little tougher for you beginners. And so we're back to some topical lessons esta semana. So hoy estamos viendo infecciones respiratorias, so upper respiratory infections. Los temas de hoy, well, here's what we're going to be doing. Los temas de hoy, síntomas respiratorios, so respiratory symptoms. Anatomía relacionada, so related anatomy for URIs. Exámenes y análisis para diagnosticar, ¿verdad? Preguntas para descartar causas. Ahora, el verbo descartar is to like rule out. And so good questions to sort of rule out different causes, okay? To get at the important information in your history. Y causas comunes de infecciones respiratorias. And then unas situaciones de práctica, so that you can take some situations, find a conversational partner and give it a shot, okay? Put it into practice. Muy bien, before we jump into todos los detalles, primero, our free Medical Spanish Masterclass is returning. We only do it a couple times a year, and so this is our last one in 2020, and I want you to know about it. I would love for you to join me and my wife, Leslie, as we teach this free Medical Spanish Masterclass. Here are some details. It runs from August 13 to August 24. You don't have to make all the sessions. You can come and go as you please. And they are 100% for you to help you have a plan for moving your medical Spanish forward. So the nuts and bolts, there are 4 recorded lessons, and then there'll be 2 live practice sessions that you'll want to try to get on your schedule. And all you have to do is register below with the link. So you can register if you're seeing this on YouTube, then register below in the more details and more information area about the video. And if you're on Facebook, go ahead in the comment box. I'll put the registration link there. And if you're viewing this video at some other time when we're not doing the masterclass, follow the link anyway, and you can get on the list for our next Medical Spanish Masterclass. All right, wonderful. Empezamos con síntomas respiratorios. Síntomas respiratorios. Primero, tos seca, tos con flema, or tos productiva. Tos is cough. Tos seca, dry cough. Tos con flema, so a cough with phlegm would be a productive cough, right? Tos productiva. Estornudo, achoo, sneezing, estornudo. Nariz tapada or congestión nasal, so stuffy nose. Nariz tapada or congestión nasal. Goteo nasal, goteo nasal. Goteo nasal is a runny nose. Gota is the word for a drop. So goteo would be like drippy, see? Drippy, goteo nasal. Fiebre, fever. Dolor de garganta, dolor de garganta. Dolor, of course, you recognize as pain. Dolor de garganta would be a great equivalent for sore throat. Bien. Falta de aire, shortness of breath. Dolor de pecho, chest pain. Dificultad para respirar. Okay, dolor de, falta de aire, shortness of breath. Dificultad para respirar. Dificultad para is difficulty doing, so difficulty breathing. Dificultad para respirar. You could actually put any verb in there that you want. And dificultad para comer. Dificultad para orinar. Difficulty urinating. Dificultad para dormir. So any verb could go here. Dificultad para respirar. Difficulty breathing. Dolor de cabeza. Calofríos. So the chills, ¿verdad? Escalofríos. Otra palabra for the chills. Dolor de los músculos. Muscle pain. Dolor de oído. Earache. Oídos congestionados, so just like stuffy ears, right? Or full ears. Dificultad para oír. Okay, dificultad para is difficulty doing something. Dificultad para oír, difficulty hearing. Silbidos, wheezing. Mucosa, flema, mocos. Okay, so mucus, mucosa, flema, phlegm. Mocos is kind of like boogery or snotty, okay? So it doesn't fit every context, or maybe mucosa y flema is más común para ti. So we can talk about some adjetivos or descripciones de mucosa: gruesa, thick; amarilla, yellow; verde, green; con sangre, with blood, ¿verdad? And then of course clara, clear. Okay, or posiblemente solo quieres hablar sobre cambios en flema, or cambios en color, cambios en la característica del flema. Okay, bien. Continuamos. Anatomía relacionada. Tenemos los senos nasales y senos frontales. So senos nasales, like the sinuses, senos frontales aquí. Okay, la frente, senos frontales, senos nasales. Okay. So, sinuses. Vías respiratorias. So, airways. Vías respiratorias. Conductos nasales. So, like your nasal passages. Okay? Conductos nasales. Faringe. Laringe. Larynx and pharynx, ¿verdad? So, pharynx and larynx. Tráquea. La tráquea. Trachea. Los pulmones. Lungs. Pulmones. Ganglios linfáticos, so your lymph nodes, ganglios linfáticos, lymph nodes, las amígdalas, when you see amígdala, you think something in the brain, pero no es, son tonsils, las amígdalas son tonsils en español, trompa de Eustaquio, la trompa de Eustaquio, trompa is a tube, and you may recognize it from fallopian tubes, trompa de Falopio. But trompa de Eustaquio, so Eustachian tubes. Membrana timpánica, so membrana timpánica, so your tympanic membrane, or el tímpano, ¿sí? Eardrum, básicamente. Ok, unos análisis y exámenes para confirmar diagnósticos. No tenemos mucho aquí, pero análisis de sangre, a blood test, ¿sí? Y cultivo de garganta, so un cultivo is a culture. En este contexto, cultivar es el verbo to grow. And so when you're taking a culture, you're growing stuff, right? So un cultivo de garganta, it's not a cultura. Please don't ever say cultura. Cultura is that common set of beliefs and norms that a particular people group have. That's cultura, culture. But cultivo is what you grow in the lab. Cultivo de garganta. So in order to do either of those, you need una muestra, a sample. Una muestra de, excuse me, muestra de sangre, blood sample, muestra de esputo, sputum sample, muestra de, you fill in the blank, orina, tejido for tissue, una muestra is your best word for sample. Radiografía del pecho, maybe overkill, but if there's TB, right? Okay, continuamos con preguntas para descartar causas. So, a few preguntas that would help you get a clear idea if we're talking viral infection, bacterial infection, etc., etc. So, primero, ¿hay otras personas en casa? Are there other people at home que tienen, who have, o recientemente han tenido, or recently have had, los mismos síntomas, the same symptoms? ¿Cuándo empezaron los síntomas? When did they start? When did the symptoms start? ¿Han cambiado? Have they changed? Es decir, ¿mejoraron y luego empeoraron de nuevo? Did they get better and then they got worse again? Okay, bien. ¿Ha tenido tos productiva? Have you had a productive cough? ¿O tos con flema? ¿Tos con sangre? ¿Ha viajado recientemente? Have you traveled recently? ¿Ha tenido fiebre? Have you had a fever? ¿Sudores en la noche? Escalofríos, chills. Sudores, sweats, right? Sudores en la noche, so sweating in the night. ¿Ha perdido el sentido de olfato? Have you lost your sense of smell? ¿O de gusto? ¿Or your taste? ¿Tiene apetito? Do you have an appetite? ¿Puede comer? Can you eat? ¿O tiene falta de apetito? Have you had a lack of appetite? ¿Ha tomado algún antibiótico? Have you taken any antibiotic? ¿Ha usado? Have you used? ¿Ha intentado? Have you tried? ¿Ha tratado? Another word to try. ¿Algún otro tratamiento en casa? So have you tried anything else at home? Okay, bien. So algunas preguntas, you could probably think of more. If you're not sure how to say them, just go ahead and put them down in the comment area below and we'll help you out with them. Okay, causas comunes para infecciones o problemas respiratorios, causas comunes. Un virus, o infección viral. Infección viral, so viral aquí is the adjective for infection, right? So un virus is the noun, infección viral. Bacteria, or infección bacteriana. Now I have bolded this one because I can't tell you how many hundreds of times in my face-to-face classes, online classes, I hear infección bacterial, which is just like the English, but bacteriana is the Spanish. So commit this one to memory, infección bacteriana. Influenza o gripe, see, influenza, so the flu. VSR, so RSV, ¿verdad? VSR, el virus sincitial respiratorio. Tosferina, whooping cough. Asma. Pulmonía o neumonía, so pneumonia. Alergias, allergies. Sinusitis, sinusitis. Bronchitis. COVID-19, obviamente, coronavirus, COVID-19. El catarro, el resfriado, so the common cold. Tuberculosis, sarampión, measles. Bronquiolitis. Estreptococo de garganta, so strep throat. ¿Sí? Mononucleosis. Y EPOC, la enfermedad pulmonar obstructiva crónica. Ok, son unas causas comunes para problemas respiratorios. Bien, ok, ahora tenemos unas situaciones para practicar con tu compañero de conversación. So, with your conversation partner, unas situaciones para practicar. Situación 1. Mujer de 23 años, 23-year-old woman, que tiene congestión nasal, so she's got congestion, fiebre y dolores de cabeza por 4 días, ok? Una situación. Situación 2. Niño de 8 años tiene estornudo, sneezing, dificultad para respirar, difficulty breathing, y goteo nasal, so runny nose. Está peor cuando juega con amigos y se esfuerza. It's worse when he plays with friends and strains. Okay? Situación 3. Hombre de 78 años tiene fiebre, tos y dificultad para respirar. So a 78-year-old male, he's got a fever, cough, and difficulty breathing. Tiene unas enfermedades crónicas, so he has some chronic conditions as well. Insuficiencia cardíaca, so heart failure, y enfisema, and enfisema. Y finalmente, situación número 4, niña de 10 meses con dificultad para respirar, so a 10-month-old girl, con dificultad para respirar, difficulty breathing, goteo nasal, runny nose, fiebre, fever, y no come, not eating, no tiene pañales mojados, doesn't have any wet diapers, y llora mucho, llora, he's crying a lot, okay? Bien, so 4 situaciones, hopefully one of those could maybe match a patient profile of yours that you could practice with a partner. If you don't have a partner to practice, your first step then would be to line out, start brainstorming some of the vocabulary that goes along with this patient, some of the questions you want to ask this patient, and then poco a poco you start putting that into Spanish and getting ready for that patient when they come through in la clínica. Ideally, to have a chance to practice con un compañero antes. And so, join the Learning Medical Spanish Facebook group if you're not already there, and float a note out there. Hey, anyone want to be a conversation partner? Do that in the Learning Medical Spanish group. Okay, muy bien. All right, no olvides, free Medical Spanish Masterclass is returning. We're starting next week, August 13th, and there will be 4 recorded lessons, 2 practice sessions, and all you have to do is register with the link below. If you are seeing this video not in this time frame, follow the link anyway and go and get your name on the list so that you have plenty of time to plan for the next free Medical Spanish Masterclass. Hasta luego. Gracias por aprender español conmigo. Juntos mejoramos comunidades. Chao.